Kazuma Sakusaka of the Japan Economic Foundation. To His Excellency, Dr. Ernest Pernia, Socioeconomic Planning Secretary, Assistant Secretary Maria Helen de la Vega of Department of Foreign Affairs, Dr. Roel Briones of the Philippine Institute for Development Studies, which is our co-host, to all of the experts from the Asia-Pacific region who have gathered here today, and to distinguished guests and ladies and gentlemen, I'm truly honored to be here today and have this opportunity to greet you. First, I would like to express my congratulations on the occasion of the 50th anniversary of the founding of ASEAN. I would also like to commend the effort of the Philippines in chairing ASEAN this year on such a commemorative timing and for hosting a successful ASEAN summit as well as other meetings. We at the Japan Economic Foundation have been hosting dialogues with the US, Europe, and Asia in order to achieve sustainable growth in the regions. And in recent years, we have been taking up constraining factors to such growth that each of our region face and have sought its solutions and learned from each other on the policy successes and failures. In Asia, we began our first Asia-Pacific Forum in 2003 in Singapore to promote FTAs in Asia-Pacific with the belief at the turn of the century that FTAs should be the key to achieving sustainable economic growth. And this year marks the 16th forum. In these years, through the mutual interaction with the progress of ASEAN economic community, the discussions have expanded to the domestic system, which are called behind the border measures, from typical border measures, such as custom duties. And we have been focusing on further improvements to the region's business and investment environment with the aim to raise the growth potential of this region. While this region is under the progress of deepening the integration of regional economies, there is a growing trend in the West that criticizes globalization as the sources of all evils on the back of wider income and asset disparities. The UK has decided to leave the EU, which was once thought to be the model of regional economic integration. The US has left TPP, and the North American Free Trade Agreement is currently being renegotiated. But losses of employment opportunities, such as desk workers seen in factories caused by free trade and investment under FTA, an institutional aspect of globalization, or is the main driver of such a change, is a technological innovation, such as robot technology and IoT, which continues to advance through AI and other new technologies. The advancement of digital society, which is called the fourth industrial revolution has cut open the walls of space, and globalization will further pick up speed with the institutional help, such as FTA. At the same time, this progress is predicted to cast both light and shadow on the domestic industrial structure and the labor environment. And the big challenge is how to manage the impact of the shadow. In the West, the trend has thus far been to approve globalization as a fundamental ideology. But this phenomenon has since turned corners to see whether there may be a better globalization. And there is a growing concern towards what the future of work will be as the fourth industrial revolution, such as AI, progresses. Luckily, as we saw at the APEC and ASEAN conferences of this month, this region continues to be on the path of dynamic economic growth, and it is the growth center of the world. Optimism is far greater than the concerns to the impact of the shadow, because there is an element of growth being able to absorb the negative aspects. There is a saying in Japan, building Buddha statue without putting in the soul. Its meaning is that you plow the field and forget the seed. Development of the institution alone, such as the FTA, does not complete the work of building Buddha statue. In other words, deepening of integration affects the domestic economy, society, and politics in each of our nations and region. Improving political and social stability through collecting the growing and persisting income and asset disparities will be a major challenge for each of our countries. It is necessary to overcome domestic, economic, social, and political challenges through dialogue with domestic stakeholders who are affected asymmetrically. In Japan, the coalition government of the Liberal Democratic Party and the Kuomintang gained approval for its growth strategies of the Abenomics at the October general election, which can be said to have been the renewal process of the social contract between the government and its people. Naturally, TPP and RCEP negotiations are means and vehicle to accelerate its own structural reform for Japan. But these mega FTAs will secure sustainable economic growth for not only Japan alone, but also for the East Asia region represented here today by further expanding direct investment, which had been a driving force of growth in this region. Each country is asked to face the challenge of disparities and create new agreements, which may be called a new social contract, as globalization and the fourth industrial revolution progress, whether each country likes it or not. Working together and moving the mega FTA forward is necessary for the growth strategy in this region to succeed. I end my remarks hoping that today's forum will further strengthen our bond in this region, promote economic integration, and contribute to the sustainable development of our economies. Thank you very much for your attention.